Greetings, everyone. This is Michael, and welcome back to the Movie Reviews. Today's film is one that I had promised to review quite some time ago, and I just actually got around to watching the film 2 days ago. As you are aware, guys, the movie is Sucker Punch. Now, this is a film by Zack Snyder, who I would have to say, guys, is one of my favorite directors. He's made quite a few films that I've really enjoyed, including Dawn of the Dead, 300, a really, really great film, The Watchmen, another equally great film, and in 2003, he's doing the upcoming Superman movie, The Man of Steel. Well, I can't help but be a little bit worried about that movie. Superman's had such bad luck when it comes to interpreting his movies on the silver screen. But tonight's review is not about any of those films. It's about Sucker Punch. Criticisms range from calling the film sexist to exploitative. Even there are those people that say Jack Snyder was just jacking off while making this film. Interesting analysis there. But there's not very many YouTubers who are my friends on this internet site that actually liked this movie. As a matter of fact, most of them hate it. There is one person that enjoyed the film that I'm a good friend with, and he made a really great review of the film. And as a matter of fact, I had not even planned on watching the film or reviewing the film until I watched his in-depth review, where it seemed like a lot of the criticisms that are heaped on the film were undeserving. And after watching the film and watching his review, I'd have to agree. Now, Sucker Punch. Now, the film stars Emily Browning, who plays Babydoll. And I'm going to try to tell just as little as I can about the story, guys, because I just hate being ruined by spoilers. But Babydoll in the film, at the very beginning, loses her mother. And her stepfather, who has sole custody of them after the passing of the mom. And when I say them, Babydoll also has a sister in the film. Now, the stepfather is definitely an unscrupulous character. At the death of Babydoll and her sister's mom, this man sets out to sexually molest them. And he is unsuccessful because Babydoll pulls a gun on him, and when she tries to shoot him, she actually nicks him, and the bullet hits her sister and kills her. So, and with that, the stepfather takes advantage of the situation and has Babydoll committed into a mental institution. And this will also alleviate the fact that he can't get any of his former wife's fortune unless the kids are out of the way. Now, the film doesn't explicitly state that even though Babydoll is in a mental institution, that the stepfather gets her inheritance, but once she gets there, he deals with an unscrupulous mental institution worker who plans on killing Babydoll at the behest of the stepfather so that he can get her riches. So once we get into the mental institution, the story kind of takes a really deviating turn. You see a series of events that take place in Babydoll's head, fantasy events that pretty much polarize the situation that she's in. During the film, events that she has to accomplish in reality are played out in her mind in a fantasy world, where the events that she's doing in reality are actually in her mind following a fantasy state. So she's acting out in true life, but acting within through a fantasy to accomplish what she needs to accomplish. And what she needs to accomplish is to gather 5 items. And if she can collect each of these items, she can win the freedom of her and her fellow female mental patients. And during the trip into the fantasy world, which actually takes place totally in her mind, guys, She deals with Scott Glenn, who pretty much I'm just going to call a wise man, which is one of his descriptions in the actual story. And he advises her on what she needs, what needs to be accomplished, and this and that. And there you have it. Now, I don't know why a lot of people hate the film, other than the fact that the conditions that I stated at the beginning of the film, where they call it sexist, it exploits women. When Babydoll fights, you see her ass, her panties, and all this kind of stuff. The women are just exploitative material. And I got to disagree with that, guys. You know, I mean, sure, you do see women's bodies, but it's a very, very tame view of these women. You don't really see much of anything, you know, than women's shapes. And the women are strong in this film. So, you know, the women take charge and take care of themselves. They're not helpless little victims that can't fight back. As a matter of fact, in most situations, they're stronger than the men. But I don't know if I suspect that a lot of people dislike this film because they feel like they were betrayed by the trailers. Now, I'm thinking, you know, I can remember seeing these trailers and thinking, wow, this looks great, a great film. And I'm imagining that, you know, once we got into viewing the film and saw that this stuff's taking place in our mind, a lot of people were probably thinking, wow, that's it? This stuff isn't even real. There's a dragon, there's these Nazi mutant soldiers, and this is all in our head. So I suspect that a lot of people were probably disappointed by the actual events in the film. Now, was I disappointed? You gotta be surprised, guys, but I am in the minority here. I actually enjoyed the movie. I had a good time with this movie. On a metaphysical level and on a reality-based level, the events in the mind of Babydoll and the events that play out in real life, I thought that Zack Snyder did a really good job of integrating these two into a very unique story. Now, this is something, guys, that may have been done before, but I've definitely never seen it before. But I watched the movie on my laptop at work the other night, and I was totally into the plight of these girls. I was into their suffering. I was into their pain. I just fell in love with the visual effects in this film. It's amazing to me that this movie cost $82 million. The visual effects were just stunning. They were set up just great. And I couldn't help but think that Zack Snyder is a visionary, the way he put this film together, the way it was cut together, the way it was edited, the CGI, which for the most part looked very, very realistic. I enjoyed the movie, guys. I just loved the fantasy elements, and I loved how the fantasy elements were tied into the reality of the situation. Now, what I would have liked to have seen that they never shown is when Babydoll dances. I would have liked to have seen what people were actually seeing in the real world, because after she dances, everybody just looks totally stunned. But they never showed it. I think they should have showed it at least once to see what was so mesmerizing about it. But Scott Glenn, I really loved his character in the film as an advisor. Just a great character. It was really good to see Scott Glenn because I hadn't seen him in so long. All the girls, got to tell you guys, just so beautiful. I mean, we had Abbie Cornish as Sweet Pea. Oh, just a totally sexy woman. I mean, all these girls were just beautiful. And I really think it's a shame that this film failed to generate a decent box office gross. I mean, it cost $82 million and only made $89 million. And I got to tell you guys, being a lover of fantasy and science fiction, I'm to a point now where theater films, all in all, are just too oversaturated with the same theme. So it was kind of refreshing to me to see a film that, you know, went against the norm. We have an actually original story here where, you know, the events are playing out in our head. I suspect that if Babydoll was actually fantasizing and dreaming up all this stuff, that in real life we'd actually been pretty good damn friends. She could have wrote a pretty good damn book too. But yeah, guys, I had a good time with this movie. Now that I've seen it, I can understand that maybe it's not everybody's cup of tea. But, you know, just being a character-based film where you see, you know, the suffering of this girl, the fact that she's in a bad situation, she's trying to protect her sister, and the plight she goes through, I'm really sympathetic to that character because she was just a very mistreated character. And I love the opening scene, guys, with Sweet Dreams playing in the background. Just totally great scene. Just the opening, just everything, just really, really creative. And I was, once again, really impressed by the level of CGI that was put into this film because it was just amazing. So, count me in the minority, guys. This is a movie that I really, really enjoyed. I understand that if you didn't, and that's really, really fine with me. I'm still your friend. So, I'm definitely going to buy the Blu-ray of this because I saw it on DVD. And I also got to say, guys, that there's an extended cut of the film, which I saw. And that's the one I definitely got to recommend. I just like this film. Really, really hated the bad guy in the movie. Just a total ass. But overall, I got to tell you guys, it was just really, really nice to see something different. Well, thanks for watching, everybody. Take care. There you have it. In a nutshell, why I like the film. And I suspect, guys, that even though the film wasn't very well received, that in the end, it will become a cult classic. Mark my words on that. Thanks for watching, everybody. Take care, and I'll see you at the next movie review.